welcome back to Destined Nation Teens. My name is Pastora Tessa, and this is Fearless Friday. But before anything else, let's gladly worship the Lord together.
I'm John, and with me is Chantel, and this is your verse of the week.
Yes, teens, for our last day of our challenge for you this week is for you to answer our question relating to our verse of the week by typing your answer on the comment box. So, John, take it away.
For our first question, what is our verse for this week? Letter A, Mark 10, verse 38. Letter B, Matthew 10, verse 38. Or letter C, Luke 10, verse 38. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That is right, teens. Letter B, Matthew 10, verse 38.
For our second question, fill in the blank. Luke 14, verse 27. And whoever does not carry his blank, O blank, and follow blank, cannot be my D blank. For our choices, our letter A, crossed my discipline. D, crossed me disciple. So teens, please answer it now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And the answer is letter B.
Lastly, take your cross here pertains to A, Jesus' desire for you, or B, carrying cross beam. 5, 4, 3, 2 and 1. That is right, teens. It's letter A, Jesus desire for you.
Congratulations for those who got 3 out of 3. Remember, carry His cross and follow Him.
See you again next week, teens. God bless.
Good day, Destination! I am Pastor Mark and welcome to What's Up, Teens! So today, we are gonna learn about social media. 1 Thessalonians 5:21, but examine everything carefully, hold fast to that which is good. So today, let's talk about multiple accounts. Some people use multiple accounts in Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and in other social media platforms. There are many reasons why people use multiple accounts in Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and other social media platforms. First is because of business. They want to use it for business. Number two, definitely kids, teenagers, and even some youth still use multiple accounts for games. Number three, fake accounts. Well, if you discovered a fake account of yourself, you should go and report it. Number four, dump photo or aesthetic feed. Number five, hiding from people. So let's talk about fake accounts. Well, there is this thing called angler phishing. It is a social media scam named after that ugly fish, scary looking fish on Finding Nemo. Angler fish uses its light to lure their prey. So it's the same thing in angler fishing. So they're gonna use this light to lure people. And they will think that they are talking to a genuine customer support or a genuine person. Sooner or later, they will find out that it's too late. They already been scammed. So people will use your identity, your credibility. Now let's talk about the aesthetic feed, which we use in Instagram. Aesthetic feed refers to the feel or look of your feed. So you have to choose the right filters because you don't want your feed to look random. But some people hide themselves with this. But in fact, they have a dump account, which they only let some few people see their photos. Why? Because they don't want others to see their photos. I don't really get why do they do so, but something to think about. And lastly, some people are hiding. Some people are making multiple accounts so that they can hide. They can hide what they're doing, what they're viewing, what they're visiting, what they are liking. And what does the Bible say about that? 1 John 1 verse 6. If we say we have fellowship with Him while we walk in darkness, we lie and do not practice the truth. So guys, do not live a double life or double lifestyle. So let us live in integrity. Proverbs 10 verse 9. Whoever walks in integrity walks securely, but he who makes his ways crooked will be found out. So guys, remember to examine everything carefully and hold fast to that which is good. This is What's Up, Teens, and you are destined for Christ.
Hello, hello, hello! I am Pastora Cristal and welcome back to this segment called Teens in Tune! And we have another song feature for you today, and that is the song Sing Like the Battle is Over by Catherine Mullins. Catherine started releasing album in the year 2008, and from that time on, she was able to release 4 studio albums. Having grown up with parents in the full-time ministry, she began speaking in church and leading worship at an early age. Wow! Catherine currently lives in Georgia, and there she attends and helps lead worship in a community church. The song Sing Like the Battle is Over is from the album with the same title released in the year 2019. This song is a reminder that God has already won the victory for us to receive. Amen? So in times of trouble, choose to remember that you just need to claim the victory that God has for you. You sing like the battle is over, dance like the war is won, and choose to remember that victory is yours before your eyes can see it. It says here in 1 Corinthians 15:57, but thanks be to God who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. So let's sing like the battle is over.
I'm gonna sing like the battle is over. I'm gonna dance like the war is won.
our song feature for today. You can check it out on the links that you can see on your screen. Destination Teens in Tune Spotify playlist. Always remember, it is important that we choose the songs that we listen to. Let God's Word always be our standard in everything. This has been me, Pastora Cristal. See you again next time. You are destined for Christ. God bless you. Hello, teens. My name is Pastora Tessa. Let me ask you, is there some fears in your heart because you have weaknesses in your life? For example, great responsibilities given by your online teacher, expectations from your parents, or you just look at somebody that is better than you and you are afraid to face tomorrow. Let me remind you to fear not, boast all the more gladly because God's power is made perfect for your weakness. And that is what Paul have confessed in his mouth because that is the promise of God. Let's read 2 Corinthians 12 verse 9. But he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. Therefore, I will boast all the more gladly of my weaknesses so that the power of Christ may rest upon me. Paul, a successful man, experienced weaknesses. Instead, seeing all those weaknesses, he boasts all the more gladly about it. In 2 Corinthians 11:30, if I must boast, I will boast all the things that show my weakness. 2 Corinthians 12:5, on behalf of this man, I will boast, but on my own behalf, I will not boast, except of my weaknesses. And in our verse, in 2 Corinthians 12 verse 9, therefore, I will boast all the more gladly of my weaknesses. So why is Paul boasting gladly about his weaknesses? He knows one thing, the power of God that he can rely. We can live by the power of God. 2 Corinthians 13 verse 4, for he was crucified in weakness but lives by the power of God. This power is the same power that raised the dead to life, the same power that God used to resurrect Jesus. And there is nothing impossible with this power of God. His power is sufficient for us. We can be made strong out of weakness. As we read Hebrews 11 verse 32 to 34, we can see men of faith who have experienced great trials in their lives. They conquered kingdoms, enforced justice, obtained promises, topped the mounts of lions, quenched the power of fire, and they were made strong out of their weakness. Became mighty in power because God is with them. They rest on the power of God. They are not defeated because of their weakness, but they know how to respond in that weakness, to rest in the promise of God. Jesus felt compassion, seeing you when you are in your weakness. And when God is compassionate to His people, He do something about it. In Hebrews 4 verse 15, for we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weaknesses, but one who in every respect have been tempted as we are, yet without sin. Teens, I want you to look at one thing right now. Paul, a successful man, he experienced weaknesses, but that did not diminish him in being successful. He faced weaknesses that didn't disappoint him. He experienced weaknesses, but he did not complain about it. Yet, he sees weakness as an opportunity for him to trust God, as an opportunity for him to rest on the power of God and not to rely on his ability. The same way with you and I, we need to learn how to respond when we are in weakness. We are out of strength to do this task, and all these things. You come to God and rest in His power. Amen, teens? Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much the promise of your power that is resting upon us. We thank you because we are not alone in this weakness. We thank you, God, that these teens will see themselves great because of the power that is in them. Thank you for the grace that causes us to work harder. Thank you for the grace that helps us not to give up. Thank you for the grace that helped us to be strong right now. And right now, God, we just want to look this all over again, oh God, in our lives, that we are not alone and we can be strong and mighty in the land. Not fearful in the situations that we have because we have you in our lives. We acknowledge you in our lives, God. We love you, God, and we give you all the glory and the honor. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Teens, once again, thank you for joining us today.
But wait, there is more.
We have Desteened service every Sundays, 5 p.m. Yes, 5 p.m. Now, I joined Desteened service since 2019 when I was 15 years old, and now I am serving God as a teens usher. In Desteened service, you will learn about God, practical tips, and more. Now, if you're curious what else is in store in Desteened service, you should experience it yourself. That's why join us now in Desteened service every Sundays, 5 p.m. via Zoom or FB Live. Always remember,
you are Desteened for Christ.
See you there!